The first core stage of NASA's new Space Launch System was built at Michoud Assembly Facility in New Orleans and shipped to Stennis for testing using intracoastal waterways. The core stage measures over 200 feet in length and is 27.5 feet in diameter. The immense size makes overland interstate travel virtually impossible. The Stennis Canal System's water level is about 10 feet above sea level, so the incoming barge had to be lifted up to canal height. This is accomplished with a Panama Canal-type lock. Using Stennis canals, the stage was moved to the B-2 test stand. This is the same stand that tested the core stage of the Apollo rockets in the 1960s and early 70s, as well as the Space Shuttle main propulsion system prior to its first flight. Once the Pegasus barge was docked at the B stand, the stage was rolled out and onto the tarmac. Once connected, two cranes took the load of the stage and the transport gear beneath it was removed. Two cranes were used to lift the stage horizontally first before going vertical so the engines on the bottom would not be damaged. This process is referred to as breakover. Once vertical, the stage was tied in place. There was an anticipated lull in the wind, so the lift was scheduled to take place the next morning. The next morning, the stage was lifted onto the B-2 stand, 11 stories high. A large crew was needed to steady and help maneuver the core stage into place before it was lowered into position for a series of tests prior to its maiden flight.